We recently looked at ways to lower our insulin resistance. But how do you know if you're insulin resistant in the first place? Today, we'll look at three methods to estimate our degree of insulin resistance and to follow it over time. And we'll throw in a bonus one at the end. Now, why would anyone want to know if they're insulin resistant? Well, people with insulin resistance are at higher risk of developing type 2 diabetes and a host of other conditions, including cardiovascular disease. And we can be insulin resistant for many years before things finally go haywire and we actually become pre-diabetic and finally diabetic. So if we can get a heads up years in advance, we can make some healthy changes and fix things instead of waiting for damage to accumulate. The best way to measure insulin resistance is a complicated lab technique called hyperinsulinemic euglycemic clamp. Just saying the name is a pain in the rear end, and performing the technique's even worse. You have to infuse both insulin and glucose into your bloodstream for a while. It's risky, it's a hassle, so it's only done in the setting of a research study. Fortunately, there are several methods that are much easier. They're not quite as precise, but they can give us a pretty good idea. The first method we're going to look at is called HOMA-IR. It stands for Homeostasis Model Assessment of Insulin Resistance. And to calculate your HOMA-IR, you need two values, your fasting insulin and your fasting glucose. Once you have those two metrics, it's just a simple formula, and you don't even need to do the math yourself. There's a lot of online calculators, so you just plug in the two values and it spits out your result. I'll link one of these calculators in the description. You can enter both milligrams per deciliter and millimole per liter, depending where you're based. Just make sure you choose the right option so the calculator knows what you're actually entering. Otherwise, the final value won't make any sense. Now, there's no universally accepted cutoff for HOMA-IR above which you say someone is definitely insulin resistant and below which someone is insulin sensitive. It's a little more gray than that. It varies with age and a couple other factors, but in general, above 2.5 or 3 is pretty suggestive of insulin resistance. And the higher you go, the more insulin resistant you probably are. You can be 6, 7, 8, etc. And under 2, in general, is a good value of someone who's pretty insulin sensitive, so not insulin resistant. Just so you know, there is another formula that uses the same readings, fasting glucose and fasting insulin. The formula is slightly different, and it's called the QUICKI index. I'll leave the puns up to you. You guys have fun in the comments. It's roughly equivalent to HOMA-IR, and the same online calculator I'm going to link for HOMA-IR also gives you the QUICKI index. So just if you hear about that, you know what they're talking about. Another tidbit to bear in mind is that these formulas that use fasting values, they mainly reflect insulin resistance in the liver, your hepatic insulin resistance. It is possible to have normal fasting metrics and yet have some insulin resistance in other tissues that is only reflected in measurements taken after eating, after a meal. There is something called the Matsuda index, which uses measurements taken postprandially, so after a meal. It's a longer test. You gotta go in and drink a sugar solution and wait a while, and you need multiple measurements at different times. So it's more of a hassle, but just so you know these things exist, that way you can have a more qualified discussion with your doctor. And the third method we're going to look at is also the easiest because it uses metrics that are very common that most people already have. Interestingly, it's also the least known. You might have never heard of it. It's called the TUIG index or the TIG index. I think it's more fun to say the TIGA, and it uses fasting glucose and fasting triglycerides. And just like the others, there's a little formula. There are several calculators, so I'll link one of those below in the description. It does all the work for you, spits out the result, even interprets it for you. Again, bear in mind the units. Make sure the units of your readings match the units on the site. Otherwise, the results are not going to make any sense. Worst case scenario, you might need to convert. And there are a number of online converters as well, from millimole per liter to milligram per deciliter, back and forth. And I'll link one of those as well in the description. A lot of people ask about triglycerides to HDL cholesterol ratio. And it does correlate with insulin resistance, but there's some evidence that these methods we covered might be a more reliable measurement, like, for example, this TYG or TIGA index probably tracks better with insulin resistance, at least in some contexts. Finally, if you just want a quick and dirty rough estimate, measuring your waist circumference is one thing you can do. It's easy, it's fast, free of charge, but obviously it's a more of a rough indicator. You want to measure it at belly button level, and ideally you want to be under 100 centimeters, which is about 40 inches. So those are some common methods. HOMA-IR, probably the most common if you have access to a fasting insulin reading. If not, the TYG or TIGA index is a pretty convenient alternative that can give you a good idea of where you are. If you are insulin resistant, what can you do about it? We covered that very recently, and this video goes over the best diets for diabetes. I'll see you over there.